Fuller seemed to have stuck hopelessly over some word and gave up his attempt to reply. "You got something very substantial out of your agreement with Sir Robert, didn't you?"
"Yes," Fuller admitted.
"Your so-called agreement with Sir Robert was then just a cold-blooded attempt on your part to exploit your unfortunate matrimonial situation for some substantial pecuniary advantage?"
"No!"
Fuller almost shouted. Mooney's suggestion seemed to be sincerely resented by him. He became very agitated, his white face flushed, and his hands trembled as he kept on adjusting his pale, horn-rimmed glasses.
I must explain,
he repeated, evidently trying to control his agitation and to speak calmly.
"It isn't true to say that I consented to this agreement from the first. I didn't consent to anything. I didn't consent to my wife's relations with Sir Robert at first, either. I told you, we were not really separated. When we first made the acquaintance of Sir Robert, we still lived together as man and wife. I mean, not really as man and wife, but we still shared one bedroom. My wife wanted a divorce, but I wouldn't agree. I still believed we could settle our differences. When my wife and Sir Robert became friends, she naturally took his view and dropped her talk about divorce. But I objected very strongly to her relations with Sir Robert. I often told him so myself. I wanted my life straightened out. I believed my wife would come round to my point of view in the end. But Sir Robert and my wife tried to get me into a false position. They tried all sorts of plots to compromise me, or at least to make it appear that I was a consenting party to their relations.